2, salute the sun. You'll need a yoga mat and a body, wearing comfy clothes. Step 1, stand straight and put your hands together in front of you.
Namaste, nice and calm.
Step 2, inhale as you reach your hands down and up above your head and arch your back. Step 3, exhale as you bend forward and touch your toes. Step 4, inhale and exhale as you stretch your right foot back into a lunge, making sure your left knee is over your left ankle. Step 5, inhale and exhale as you stretch your left foot back into a plank. Looking good.
Aww, thank you very much.
Step 6, bring your knees down, then your chest down, so you're lying flat with your palms still flat on the ground and elbows bent, like a cobra. Step 7, inhale and exhale as you jump to your feet and straighten your arms, palms still on the ground in a downward dog position. Step 8, inhale and exhale as you bring your left knee forward back into a lunge.
It's lunge time again? I just ate!
Step 9, bring your right foot forward to meet your left and go back into a forward bend. Step 10, slowly inhale as you bring your body up and your arms out and up above your head, arching your back. Step 11, exhale as you bring your arms down and your hands together in front of you, where you started.
And remember, if you don't get it in your first try, yoga to try it again.
How to beatbox. You'll need a mouth, the kick drum. Puff your cheeks, then let the air out while mouthing the B sound. Buh, buh.
Buh, 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 buh. Buh, buh, buh.
Yo, 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 the letter B is the place to be.
Do the same thing with the letters BS.
Psst.
BF. And BSH. Mix them up to create a rhythm. The hi-hat. Put your teeth together. Let out a short burst of air while making a TS sound.
Oh yeah! Your hi-hat is all dead!
The snare drum. Puff your cheeks, then let the air out while mouthing the P sound. Puh, puh.
Puh, 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 puh.
Mix things up with PS. PF. And PSH. Mix them up to create a rhythm.
Like you just don't care.
The crash cymbal. Clench your teeth and repeat the sound. Combine all four sounds and make your own beat.
Sprout, Boy Scout, Sauerkraut, now I'm out!
How to speak pig Latin. You'll need a pig. Just kidding. If a word starts with a consonant, that's these letters, move that consonant to the end of the word and add A. So pickles becomes Icklespay, and furry becomes Urifay. Say it! Urifay, Icklespay. Again, Urifay, Icklespay.
Oats-tay, ooh-kay.
If a word starts with two consonants, move both consonants to the end and add A. So grandma becomes Anne Mugray. Say it, Amagre. Again, Anmagre. And if a word starts with a vowel, that's these letters, just add the word way to the end. So airplane becomes airplane way, and awesome becomes awesome way. Say it! Awesome way, airplane way. Again, awesome way, airplane way. Put them all together, and you're speaking Pig Latin.
Easy way, easy pay.
Why may, awesome way, amagre, eats way, urife, ickles pay, in way, airplane's way. Say it. Why may, awesome way, amagre, eats way, urife, ickles pay, in way, airplane's way.
No way. My awesome grandma eats furry pickles and airplanes too.
One hey way. Do the pig Latin dance.
Here from Next Generation and Dance Fusion. I am also the choreographer for Blazer Fresh. And I'm here with Blazer Fresh themselves, Mr. Onstar, Xavier, and my man Rashid. So, and we are going to take you through the hottest dance style right now, the floss. So, here's what I would like for you guys to do. You guys ready?
Yep.
You ready? Okay, so you're going to take your hands and you're going to put them out in front of you like you have a stick. Now put it down towards your hips and turn it a little bit out this way. Now what I want you to do is I want you to break the stick with your hip, pull it back out, switch, and then break the stick on the other side with your hip, and then pull it back out. There you go. So let's do that slow. Cross, break, out, cross, break, out. Nice, ready? Cross, break, out, cross, break, out. Faster, please. Cross, break, out. Cross, break, out. Cross, break, out. Cross, break, out. Oh, y'all like professionals.
I mean, okay,
I let's speed that up. 5, 6, 7, hit it. Cross, break, out. Cross, break, out.
That's
that
bad.
Cross, break, out. Cross, break, out. All right, you got that? I know what you're waiting for, some music. Can I get some music, DJ Robbie Ra? 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and cross, break, out, cross, break, out, cross, break, out, cross, break. What? You want us to speed up? Oh, they want us to speed up. Speed it up. Cross, break, out, break, out, cross, 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 break, out, slow, slow, slow. Speed it up. Ooh. And that is the floss. Thank you guys for tuning in. Stay tuned. See you and stay laser fresh.
Yeah.
One more for the road.
One more for the road?
I know you like it.
And
I learned a new thing.
Look at me, mom.
I'm flossing. Right. I'm flossing. I'm flossing. I'm
flossing. What does team day say?
How to address an envelope. You'll need an envelope, a pen, a stamp, and a letter to mail.
Squatchy no use paper. Squatchy carve stone.
Step 1. Write the return address that's your address in the upper left corner of the envelope. On the first line, write your full name. Ryteam. That's my name. You write your name. On the second line, under your name, write your street address. 2U Road. Get it? Writing 2U? Ha! Okay, that's not really my name. On the third line, under the street address, write your city and state. Letterville, New York. On the fourth line, write your 5-digit zip code. 07734. Step 2. Write the receiver's address in the center of the envelope.
Squatchy invite friend to cake party.
On the first line, write his or her full name. Go Noodle. I'm writing to Go Noodle. On the second line, write their street address. 209 10th Avenue South. On the third line, write their city and state. Nashville, Tennessee. On the fourth line, write their five-digit zip code, 37203. Step 3, put a stamp in the upper right corner. Step 4, put your letter in the envelope, seal it, and drop it in the mailbox.
Uh-oh, still no fitted mailbox. Squatchy need paper.
This is Go Noodle's address. Send us a letter. We would love to hear from you.
Right to Squatchy.
How to make a fortune teller. You'll need a pen, four different color markers, and a square piece of paper. If you don't have a square piece, make one. Fold down a corner of a rectangular piece, forming a triangle. Fold the remaining rectangular piece one way, then the other. Again, and again, and again, and again, and again, forming a deep crease. Rip off the rectangular piece and open the triangle. Check it out, a square. Now onto the fortune teller. Step 1, fold the paper in half, and then in half again, creating crease lines. Step 2, fold the paper in half diagonally, and then diagonally again, then open. See? More creases.
Hey, I can predict the future. You're gonna fold that paper again.
Step 3, fold the top right corner so the point is in the middle of the square.
Told ya!
Step 4, do the same with the other three corners. Fold, fold, fold. Step 5, turn the smaller square over and fold down the top corner to the middle of the square. Step 6, do the same with the other three corners. Fold, fold, fold.
I predict more folding.
Step 7, fold the new, even smaller square in half.
Right again!
Step 8, slide your thumbs and your pointers under each flap and use them to open and close your fortune teller.
Hello!
Step 9, flip over your fortune teller and label each square with four colors. Orange, green, purple, blue. Step 10, flip it over and label all eight triangles with a number. Step 11, open up all of the flaps and write predictions like, yep, no way, possibly, definitely, probably not, in your dreams. Yeah, you know it. And sorry, no dice. Step 12, fold it back up, put your fingers in, and find a friend. Have your friend ask a yes-no question like,
does this fortune teller really predict the future?
Tell them to pick a color.
Purple.
And spell it out as you move the fortune teller. P-U-R-P-L-E.
Purple is my favorite color!
Tell them to pick a number.
4.
No way! I was going to say 4!
And move the fortune teller that many times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tell them to pick another number.
7.
No way! I was going to say 7!
And move the fortune teller that many times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Tell them to pick one last number.
2.
No way! I wasn't going to say 2. I was going to say 6. Oh well.
Open the flap for your answer. Does this fortune teller really predict the future? Yeah, you know it.
Wait, what did it say for 6? Hello? Hello? Where did everyone go?
How to read someone's mind. You'll need a piece of paper, a pen, and a friend to freak out.
You can't fool me!
Step 1. Write the word carrot on a piece of paper. Step 2. Give the paper to your friend and tell them not to look at it yet. Step 3. Ask, what's 1 plus 1? And wait for their answer.
Easy! The answer is 2!
Step 4. Ask, what's 2 plus 2?
Piece of cake! 4!
Step 5. Ask, what's 4 plus 4?
8! Don't waste my time!
Step 6. Ask, what's 8 plus 8?
16! Bam! Anything else?
Step 7. Ask your friend to name a vegetable.
I'll go with carrot.
90% of the time, your friend will say carrot. Step 8. Tell them to look at the paper and watch them freak out. No one knows exactly how this works, but it almost always does. Mine read and blown.
What? But I... you... how?
Train your brain to do more cool tricks with this.
Hold your pinky on one hand up like Mr. Catman. On the other hand, make the letter L with your thumb and index finger. Meow. At the same time, switch your pinky to the L and the L to the pinky. Slowly at first. Mew got it. Switch your pinky to the L and the L to your pinky. Try it a little faster. This is plausibly one of the most difficult exercises. Why? Because Mr. Catman likes to challenge your brain. But it's all good, because practice makes perfect. For real.
How to blow a grass trumpet.
We in the music scene call that a grumpet, you dig?
You'll need a wide blade of grass and your thumbs. Step 1, pick a blade of grass. The wider, the better. Step 2, hold the grass on its side between your thumbs. Step 3, blow into the space between your thumbs. The grass will vibrate and make a trumpet sound.
I love the sweet sounds of the grumpet. Add some drums and a guitar, and you've got yourself a grass band. You dig?
Do the grass trumpet dance.
Salutations, everybody. This is Sibo from Next Generation. I am also the choreographer of Blazer Fresh. And I am here with Blazer Fresh themselves. So let me introduce you to my peoples. This is OnStar.
Yeah, what's up?
Rasheen.
What's up, baby?
X on High.
Got you, bro.
How you doing? And we're about to take you through some of the more famous dance steps that are out today. Ooh. Are you ready to join me? You ready to learn some new steps? I'm going to teach you how to do a step called the dab.
Look at my dab.
You know how to dab?
Look at my dab.
You know how we dab?
How we do it?
So I'm going to show you how to do the dab. So the first thing you want to do is you want to take one hand, you want to bring it up, you want to bring it down, and the other hand is going to go out to the side.
Okay.
One more time. Hand up, down, out to the side. Now you're going to do both at the same time. So up, down. One more time. And up, down. Let's try it on the other side. Up, down. One more time. Up, down. Now this little fact that you need to know about the dab is it's not a step by itself. It's an exclamation point.
Yes.
So you put it at the end of your steps. So you never just do a dab by itself. You do something into a dab, yes?
See?
You get that?
I get, that?
It's like you order a pizza, you go, can I get a pizza? And he goes, yeah. And you go, nice. Dab.
Oh.
You know, fire. You need a cab, you hail a cab, it comes up, you're like, nice.
Dab.
Woo! You feel me? That's how you do the dab. So let's take one step to the left, one step to the right. Hit me with it.
Dab.
Oh, I like that.
One more time to the left.
Uh-huh.
To the right.
Okay.
Hit me with it.
Dab.
Hey, can we get some groove on that?
Let's get some groove.
Yes. Down, down,
okay.
Down, down,
I'm with you.
To the side and then back, and then hit me with the dab. Ready? Okay. 5, 6, 7, let's go. Step and step and
step.
Hey, one more time. Step
and step and
cool.
Hey, one more time.
Hey, what's up?
That's how we do it.
That's how we
can
do it.
Can I get some music so we can dab this out?
Now,
the thing about the dab is, like I said, you can do whatever you want. So you don't have to do the two steps. You can do three steps, four steps, whatever you want to do. Hit it with the dab. So this is two steps for now.
All right.
Six, seven, and.
Go.
Step.
All right.
And step. And step.
Step.
Hey, hey, let's go.
And step.
Step.
And step.
Step. Step.
Step. Step. Step. Step.
Hey, mix it up. Go.
Oh.
Hey. Hey.
Damn.
What? Hey. One more time.
Ho.
Hey.
Ho. Ho.
Ho.
Damn.
Ho. Hey. Hey.
Suck it. Suck it down.
Hey. And
damn.
What? One more game.
Let me.
Hey.
Let me.
Bam! Hey, one more time!
Bam!
Hey!
Woo!
Slow motion! And
two!
Did you catch that?
Hey!
Hey! Hey!
Hey!
Hey!
Hit it with it!
Bam!
Ah! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Bam!
Oh! Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! The music's
on. Now bring it back. That's how we do the dab. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope you guys had fun with that. Come back and enjoy it with Blazer
Fresh.
Fresh. Dab.
How to draw Bart Reynolds.
I'm part cowboy, part movie star. Oh, mustache.
You'll need a piece of paper, a pencil, an eraser, and a black, pink, brown, red, and blue marker. Step one. Use your pencil to draw two ovals for his eyes. One eye, the other eye. Draw a smaller oval inside one of the bigger ovals, and then an even smaller one inside that. Repeat. Small oval, teensy oval. Step two, draw a triangle with rounded edges for his body. Like this. Step three, on the bottom of the triangle, draw two skinny legs. One, two.
My legs may be skinny, but my stash is extra strong.
Step four, draw Bart some boots. Boot. Boot. Step five. Draw some hair above his eyeballs. Nice do. Step six, it's stash time.
This is what it's all about, y'all.
Start in the middle of his body and draw two lumps. One, two. And then a line, then a hand, some fingers, then the other side of his arm, then a little elbow. Then bring your pencil back to where you started.
Yee-haw!
For the other half, go back to where you started and do the same thing again. Two lumps, one, two. Then an arm, then a hand, some fingers, then the rest of his arm, then an elbow, then back to the start.
Most muscular mustache in the West.
Step seven, add the details. Big, chunky eyebrows. And trim for his boots. Gotta make them snazzy. Step eight. Erase the body lines inside the stash. Bye-bye, lines. Step nine, go over all your pencil lines with a black marker. Just trace the whole thing to make his body really stand out. And color in his eyebrows, too. Step 10, color the rest of him in. I'll speed up this part. pink body, brown mustache arms, brown hair, red boots, blue legs.
You're gonna wanna stash this drawing in a safe place so you can shave it for later. Oh.
Ta-da!
How to!
It's all about the stash.
How to say hello in 15 different languages. You'll need a voice. One, French. Bonjour. 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 Say it. Bonjour. Two, Croatian. Ba. 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 Say it. Ba. Three, Danish. Hi.
I like my Danish with strawberry jam.
Hi. Hi. Say it.
Hi. Four, Chinese. Ni hao.
Ni hao. Ni hao. Say it.
Ni hao. Five, Swahili. Habari.
Habari. Habari.
Say it. Habari. Six, Slovak. Ahoy.
Slovak? How do you say it in fastback?
Ahoy. Ahoy. Say it.
Ahoy. Seven, Italian. Ciao.
Ciao. Ciao. Say it.
Ciao. Eight, Russian. Privyet.
Privyet. Privyet.
Say it. Privyet. Nine, Japanese. Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. Konnichiwa.
Say it. Konnichiwa. 10. Arabic. Assalamualaikum. 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 Say it. Assalamualaikum. 11. Finish. Hey.
Wait, we're not finished. We have four more to go.
Hey. Hey. Say it.
Hey. 12. Latin. Salve.
Salve. Salve. Say it.
Salve. 13. Irish.
Giadich. 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 Say it.
Giadich. 14. Hebrew.
Shalom. Shalom. Shalom.
Say it.
Shalom.
15. Zulu.
Sawubona. Sawubona. Sawubona.
You say it.
Sawubona.
Now it's time to say Vizan to Latasha. That's goodbye in Hungarian.
I'm still Hungarian for that Danish.
Say hello to Squatchy Burger.
Yo, Squatchy.
Yo, yo.
Show us how you say hello.
I move like this and go with flow, and then I say aloha, you know?
Aloha.
Aloha.
Aloha, aloha, aloha. Hello.
Hello.
How to make ice cream in a bag. You'll need 2 cups of whole milk, 1/2 cup of granulated sugar, 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract, 8 tablespoons of rock salt, 1 sandwich-sized resealable bag, 1 gallon-sized resealable bag, and 1 large bowl of ice cubes.
Flavorings and toppings optional.
Here I am. Hope I'm not too late.
Step 1. Fill the sandwich bag with the milk, sugar, and vanilla. For chocolate ice cream, add 1 tablespoon of unsweetened cocoa powder. For strawberry ice cream, add 2 chopped strawberries. For mint chocolate chip ice cream, add 1/4 teaspoon of peppermint extract and 1 tablespoon of chocolate chips. They're in there.
You just can't see them.
Please shave some chocolate chip for me.
Step 2. Push out the excess air and seal. Step 3. Fill the larger gallon-sized bag with the ice and rock salt.
Stash it away, you might say.
Step 4. Put the smaller bag inside the larger bag and shake it with all you've got for 7 to 10 minutes. Trade off with a friend if you get tired. Shake, shake, shaky shake. Almost done shaking.
Step 5. Take the smaller bag out of the larger bag and scoop it into 2 bowls.
Step 6. Add your favorite toppings, grab a friend, and dig in. This is really good.
Must ask you for a taste. Get it?
Do the ice cream workout. Shake, 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 shake. I'm shaking. Shake it up. Shake, shake. Keep on shaking. You got this. Keep shaking. Shaking. Shake, shake. Keep on shaking. You got this. Keep shaking. Don't stop shaking. Just a little more shaking. Shake, shake, shake.
How to make oobleck.
Oobleck is a scientific phenomenon. It's a liquid, like water, and a solid, like a rock, at the same time. I didn't invent it, but I could have.
You'll need a mixing bowl, a measuring cup, a spoon, cornstarch, water, and food coloring. Step 1. Add 1 3/4 cups of cornstarch to the bowl.
Cornstarch is a powdery substance made from the inside of a kernel of corn.
Step 2. Measure 1 cup of water and add in 10 drops of food coloring. The more drops you add, the darker it gets.
Water is... never mind. You know what water is, right?
Step 3. Slowly pour the colored water into the cornstarch as you stir.
This is where the scientific magic happens.
Step 4. Keep stirring. It's tough until it blends together and starts to thicken and become oobleck. Pick up a bunch. Squeeze it tightly in your hand, and it's solid like a ball. Open up your hand, and it turns to liquid and drips through your fingers. Ooey gooey oobleck. This stuff is fun. How cool is this?
It's a solid! It's a liquid! It's alive! It's alive! Sorry. I got carried away there.
Feel the oobleck. Be the oobleck. Go from a solid to a liquid. Solid and melt. 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 I'm oobleck.
It's alive!
How to make hand shadow puppets. You'll need a wall, a light, and your hands. Here's the dog. Put your hands halfway between the light and the wall. Stretch your hand out so your 4 fingers are pointing forward. Bend your pointer finger. Stick up your thumb to make the ear.
What up, dog?
The deer. Hold out one hand, bringing your pointer and pinky over your middle and ring finger and fold down your thumb. This is the deer's face. Bend your other hand back at the wrist and curl your fingers to make the antlers. Rest the antlers on top of the deer's head. Hey, what do you call a deer with no eyes?
No idea.
Exactly. The grumpy old man. Turn your hand upside down. Make a fist. Stick out your middle knuckle to make his nose. Use your thumb as his mouth.
This soup is too cold. This music is too loud. This couch is too couchy.
Hi, I'm McPufferson.
Why is this great talking to me?
The bird. Put your hands halfway between the light and the wall. Link your thumbs together. Stretch out your hands to make the wings.
McGawk!
Polly want a cracker? Yikes! McPufferson, out!
McGawk!
circles with your hands, now do it with your body. The dog. Turn your body into an upside down V. And hold for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The deer. Bend both legs and touch your front leg to your back knee. Lie forward like a sleeping deer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The bird. This one's a pigeon. Leave your front leg where it is and extend your back. Lean forward and back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The old man. Now, there is no old man pose, so just lie down and take a nap.
How to make unicorn goo slime.
I love unicorns. Yay, unicorns! Did I mention I love unicorns?
You'll need 3 6-ounce bottles of glitter glue in different colors. For each bottle of glue, you'll need 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 tablespoon of contact lens solution, 2 bowls, 1 spoon, an airtight container, and a little bit of water.
Can you repeat those again? I was daydreaming about unicorns.
Step 1, cover your table with newspaper so you don't slime things up. Step 2, squeeze most of a bottle of glue into a bowl. Step 3, put the baking soda in a small bowl, add a little bit of water, and stir it up. Step 4, add the baking soda mixture to the glue and stir it on up. Step 5, add the magic ingredient, the contact lens solution. This activates the glue and turns it into slime. Step 6, stir it with a spoon until most of the contact solution is mixed in. You can keep stirring it with your spoon, or you can use your hands to squish and squash the slimy mixture all over the bowl until it becomes stretchy, gooey slime. Note, if it's too sticky, give your hands a little squirt of the contact lens solution. Step 7, repeat this process with the other 2 colors. Put the glue in the bowl, mix the baking soda and water, add it to the glue, pour in the contact solution, stir it, knead it, pull it, done. Put the glue in the bowl, mix the baking soda and water, add it to the glue, pour in the contact solution, stir it, knead it, pull it, done. Step 8, break off a little piece of each color, whirl each one into a log, and then twist it so the colors swirl together. Look, I'm a unicorn.
Wait, what are we making? It's not that I'm forgetful. It's just that I have a hard time remembering things.
Stretch and squeeze your unicorn slime as much as you want. Mix it together or keep it separate. And when you're not using it, store it in an airtight container and use it to decorate your room.
Unicorn slime? Awesome! So, how do you make it?
You made the goo, now what you gonna do? Dance.